it was the government's PM-KISAN scheme, the promise of rupees 6,000 a year to small and marginal farmer households. And now the Congress has announced an income support scheme of rupees 6,000 a month to the poorest 20% of India. Will these election time cash handout schemes tilt voters towards these parties, as these parties hope? And also, do they come close to crossing the election Lakshman Rekha? Of the two schemes, the Congress's and the government's, the model code applies directly to PM-KISAN, since that's a pre-election policy announcement. By the time the code had kicked in, the government had already paid the first installment of rupees 2,000 rupees to about 2.8 crore beneficiaries. Now the Election Commission, in response to an inquiry by the government, has given the go-ahead to pay out the second installment to those already in the system, the Election Commission clarifying that no new beneficiaries can be paid. Based on government data, at the time when the model code kicked in, of the total 12 crore households the scheme hoped to target, the data of 4.7 crore beneficiaries is already in the system. So as we said, about 2.8 crores have been paid, so about 5,600 crores has already been paid out. By the 31st of March, the government hopes to cover all 4.7 crore beneficiaries for the first round. And now they have the go-ahead to release the second tranche of rupees 2,000 from 1st April onwards. This will be deep in election season. All in all, the government may end up paying rupees 19,000 crores to about 10 crore voters bang in the middle of election season. This is assuming two voters per household for about 4.7 crore household. That works out to about 10 crore voters. Now, the Congress scheme is estimated to cover about 5 crore households. Shruti Menon travelled to rural Haryana to gauge whether cash handouts, real or promised, are tilting the political scales.
Haryana's Bhiwani, 2 hours west of Delhi. Here in a village of Jats, we ask who has received payments under PM Kisan.
2,000 rupees, how many people have come to the account? Raise your hand. Have you also come? No,
As per government data of Haryana's around 12 lakh small and marginal farmers, over 9 lakh have been cleared for payment. But even those who got the money seem upset.
लोगों को बैक आने के लिए ड्रामाबाजी कर रखी है 100% में से सिर्फ पास को मिलेंगी सिर्फ ये वोट के लिए लालच लोगों को ड्रामाबाजी दिखा रखी है
तो क्या लेकिन आपको पैसे मिल गए तो आपका
पैसे तो मिल गए लेकिन एक को मिल गए तो क्या होता है एक से और भी तो भाई है सारे किसान गरीब आदमी है उनको भी चाहिए सबको
ऑल ऑफ दीस फार्मर्स से दे सपोर्टेड द बीजेपी इन द 2014 इलेक्शंस दिस टाइम डिस्पाइट पीएम किसान they seem less convinced.
जो बीजेपी को आएगा उससे उम्मीद है चाहे कोई पार्टी हो बीजेपी को वोट नहीं देंगे
वोटों की राजनीति कर रहे हैं साढ़े चार साल हो गए पहले क्यों नहीं दिए पहले भी तो देना था साढ़े चार साल हो गए वोटा टाइम इलेक्शन का टाइम कर रखा है
But in the neighboring district of Rohtak, evidence of the demand for the scheme. Farmers who haven't gotten the money sitting in protest outside a government building.
मेरे पिताजी हैं काफी बुजुर्ग उनकी 4 एकड़ से कम जमीन थी और मैंने 12 फरवरी को फार्म भरया था पटवारी आए थे गांव में
ये आपका फॉर्म है
नहीं ये मैंने फॉर्म भर के दे दिया था वो ले गए थे फोन नंबर मैंने लिख दिए थे अपने मेरे पिताजी फोन नहीं रखते बुजुर्ग हैं और मैं यहाँ 14 से पहले मैंने SDM श्यापला को शिकायत करी थी फिर DDA को करी आज भी DDA से मेरी बात हुई थी फोन पर तो उन्होंने मैंने पूछा मां जी वो फार्म भरे थे वो कहाँ है उन अभी कोई जानकारी नहीं मिल रही कहाँ मंगा रिजेक्ट हो गए या मिलेगी लेकिन कोई जवाब नहीं
As with PM Kisan, people in Bhiwani in a small village called Ninan seemed skeptical of the Congress's cash transfer scheme. These people are BJP voters and they said that this scheme is unlikely to get them to switch.
कांग्रेस में हमारे बाप दादे मर के बुढ़े हो गए इब टाइम मर दे कोई फायदा नहीं पाया हमने
This woman says she does not even have a below poverty line card which may be needed to make her eligible for the scheme
हम न तो उम्मीद है नहीं हमारे राशन कार्ड ही नहीं बने ये बीपील तो उनकी उम्मीद कहां से होगी हम तो अनु बता रहे हैं हम न तो नु अभी मारा नहीं बुला रहा तो और सबका तो हो रहा है भला इसमें हम तो देवेंगे तो वोट तो इसी की देवेंगे जीपी की इसके जीपीसी के
बीजेपी Most people did not know about the Congress's scheme, but those who were told by us did not seem convinced. So can this really be a game changer for the Congress? With camera person Shashi Kanja, Shruti Menon in Haryana for NDTV.
All right, joining us tonight on Reality Check, we have Ashok Thakur with us, leader of the BJP. Great to always have you. Also joining us, Sharmista Mukherjee, spokesperson of the Congress, is with us. Via Skype, we have Susmit Patra, spokesperson of the BJD. And last but not the least, Nitin Sethi, associate editor, Business Standard. Nitin, just to start off now with PM Kisan, because this is sort of interesting that you're going to have a situation where if the government so chooses, they can release close to, they've already released about 5,000 crores already, this is before the model code, another 15,000 crores bang in the middle of election season to, as we said, about 10 crore voters.
I mean, one could easily see this as a incremental inducement during election season. It, as your report also shows, it will tilt a few people, it may not tilt everyone. Also, hastily done schemes we've seen in the past, very close to elections, also raises anger.
Hmm.
It raises expectations. Suddenly, if they don't meet, there is friction that appears in those.
We've so, it seen can reports. Go both ways.
It cuts both ways. I think we've seen these reports already emerging for a few states where the money is either not reaching the right people, etc., etc. So, it can play both ways. But on the overall issue of whether it's right at this moment, I think technically the government gets through. On a moral quotient, it's really questionable.
Right. Ashok ji, congratulations. Aapke toh, this is like a bonanza for you. You can release, as I said, 19,000 crores to 10 crore voters in the middle of election season. I can't remember the last time something like this has happened. This is like officially sanctioned government cash payouts, virtually.
Earlier also I said that government has, whatever government has declared and whatever government is giving, it is within the constitutional framework. And once constitutional allow,
then is why, it right though? Why it should be questioned? Because it's just before the election.
And another thing, one more thing what I want to say here, we have decided and we are giving. And what Congress is doing, they always, they said, but they never given.
Congress,
that is the difference.
Congress, I'm coming to in a minute, but I was just on this PM Kisan for the moment. I want to bring in Mr. Sashmit Patra, because Mr. Patra, now the BJD has a grievance. You are claiming that your own scheme, as in the state government scheme called Kalia, which is also an income transfer scheme to farmers, you're saying that that has been stopped, but PM Kisan is being allowed. Clarify that.
Firstly, actually, it has not been stopped directly because the chief electoral officer of the election commission wants, you'll be shocked to know that the Kalia Yojana, which provides benefits to 20 lakh farmers of the state, and it was implemented much well before the model code of conduct came, and was also much before PM Kisan, in fact, came.
Right.
You'll be surprised to know it was the Bharatiya Janata Party which went to the chief electoral officer who's heading the nodal agency of election commission for the state and said, stop the Kalia Yojana for the farmers. Do not give them the money to the Kalia Yojana for the farmers. This is the same BJP which talks about farmers. It's extremely unfortunate that
But what's the election commission stand on it? Are they saying to you that you can't pay the existing beneficiaries already enrolled? Or are they saying that you can only not enroll fresh beneficiaries, which is what they've said for PM Kisan as well? Can you hear me? Okay, Sasmith Patra, we'll just come back to you in a second. But can I just bring in Sharmista Mukherjee here of the Congress, Sharmista, because this is going to be a political challenge for you, that the government effectively has in its hands a legally sanctioned tool sanctioned by the Election Commission to continue to make cash payments through election season.
You know, as shown by your own report, that people are not impressed by it because they see through BJP's game plan.
You know, just to qualify, that was from one village, you know, one location.
For 5 years. You know, but that also might be one location. But, you know, this also is reflective of mood of the people. But, you know, the one thing is that, you know, BJP, and rightly pointed by one of your audiences, that abhi tak kya so rahe the? You know, this government's anti-farmer policy has created havoc in the rural India, in the rural economy. Right. You know, they have given, after promising in their pre-poll, they have, you know, stopped, they have given, opposed, you know, 50% plus cost plus MSP plus 50%
but, you know,
cost.
Leaving that aside,
they have given an affidavit in the Supreme Court. And now, know, now they are, you know, just 2 months before the election, they are just giving,
but
you know,
isn't
cash.
Isn't this a political challenge for you? 1 second.
Can you justify the debate. Congress so states why they are not BJP, giving data and why they are not allowing
BJP
the farmers to get money?
Okay, but
why Congress?
But Sharmista, just a second, Ashok ji.
We have within coming 10 days, you know, in some states 2 days, in some states 10 days, you know, we have
Rajasthan, Chattisgarh, and Madhya Pradesh, they weren't allowed any farmers to get
okay,
the money.
That's a different debate.
And what happened to your?
Okay, Ashok ji, not both. No, 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 not both at the same time. Not both at the same time.
2,50,000.
Okay, okay. No, no, 1 second, Ashok ji. Ashok ji, 1 second, one at a time.
You told them that you will
waive off one at a time. One at a time.
You have not done that.
Okay, one at a time.
But you have done there.
One at a time. All right, we have Arvind. We have Arvind Mayaram with us. Okay, Sharmista, I'll come back to you.
5 years.
Okay,
so
Sharmista, I'll come back to you. No, 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 1 second. No, no, no. Please. Let me. No, no, no. Let me just go to my next guest. I'll come back to you. Ashok ji, just a second. Arvind Mayaram, thank you for joining us, former finance secretary. We are coming to the Congress scheme in just a second. But on the point of PM Kisan, I'm not sure if you caught the top of our show where essentially now the Election Commission has said you can continue to pay out existing beneficiaries, sir. So that means the government can make these transfers right through election season. One tranche goes through before March 31st, the other one anytime 4 months after April. So that could be, you know, right through the polling period. Is that something which, I mean, again, you know, this is not to sort of question the Election Commission's wisdom, but does this raise some questions of propriety?
Technically, perhaps what the Election Commission has said may be right, but there is certainly a moral question here. We have for a very long time held that once the model code of conduct is been declared, then all the benefits, etc., which would affect the elections in any way, should not be given by the government in question. So, I certainly think there may be a moral question, but technically perhaps the Election Commission is right. So, it's difficult to say anything further on that.
Right. Okay, can I just go back now to Susmit Patra if we have him back? Do we have him back? Okay, it's all checked. Yes, Susmit Patra, sorry, go ahead. I was trying to ask you, Susmit Patra, that what exactly are you objecting to, because the Election Commission in the case of PM Kisan says that you can pay existing beneficiaries. Is that also being allowed to you?
You see, the chief electoral officer has clearly stated that you cannot transfer anything to anyone. Now, that's the whole problem. On one hand,
anybody,
if you are allowed...
Even those who are in the system.
Absolutely. You see, right now we have paid already 20 lakh farmers, you know, the proceeds of 1,500 crores already, and they are waiting for the next tranche to come in, which will prepare them for the cropping season, which is going to come in June. And right now, on one hand, PM Kisan has been given the green light. On the other hand, the state-run Kalya Yojana, which came much earlier than the PM Kisan by almost a month and a half.
So
imagine.
So what are you doing about it? Are you going to protest? Are you going to object? Are you going to raise this with the EC?
Absolutely. You see, for the last twice, we have been to the chief electoral officer when he was being pressurized by the Bharatiya Janata Party delegations to tell him, sir, do not get pressurized by the Bharatiya Janata Party. It is undemocratic. And after this has happened, we're going to move to the Election Commission of India and we're going to raise it very strongly.
Okay, let me just get in a quick reaction from you, Ashok Thakur, before I move on now to the Congress's scheme and whether that also amounts to, in a sense, a kind of pre-poll inducement. How is this then applying? I mean, one could turn around and say that both should have been stopped, but the fact that there's double standards, they're alleging. Kalia is stopped. You are putting pressure there saying, don't make those payments, but you're happily making your payments.
See, Dr.
Patra.
Patra.
Not Sambit Patra, he says
not Sambit Patra. we have sent Sambit Patra to Puri and he will see all.
Okay, on the point. Yes.
But I am saying, if they are not technically correct, if it is not within the constitutional framework, then naturally election commission might have stopped it.
Right.
They have no point. He is unable to justify this.
Right.
And he is also unable to quote the reason why they stopped it. If you will go in the deep roots, you will find that election commission may be correct.
Okay.
And
well, we'll
if he is doing wrong, then they have the platform to go.
Election commission is on the
they
point
can protest
of
also.
Law. Okay. But coming Nitin to the Congress plan, the Congress handout. I'll just come back to you, Dr. Patra. I'm coming back to you on the Congress plan. Where do you think? I mean, there are still several questions about it. And, you know, you did an extensive interview, you repeat his piece as well with Praveen Chakravarti of the Congress, trying to explain what it was. Where do you think that stands when it comes to this question of propriety?
I think there's no question of propriety there.
It's a promise.
It's a promise made in a manifesto. All parties are legitimately allowed to make whatever promises they make in the manifesto. Fair game. I mean, the larger questions of how that scheme would work, where does it drive us as a development welfare state, etc.
Right.
But as far as the question of can the Congress party offer that to the citizens as what they should choose, obviously, it's his fair game.
But do you feel that it has addressed all the questions, or does it seem a very hastily put together job? Because I think even the sort of reporting you did on it and the details we've got as well, we can put up some of those questions. I mean, you know, is it going to subsume other subsidy schemes? That's not very clear. Where the money is going to come from, that's not very clear. So there are still, and there was also this confusion with Rahul Gandhi saying it's a top-up scheme and the Congress then having to come out and clarify. So it doesn't look like they're fully thought it through.
So I think two or three things, it's very clear, but it comes out rather naturally from the scale at which the Congress is proposing this idea. You're looking at around 3.5 lakh crores at its peak,
yes,
which is roughly equal to the total centrally sponsored schemes that the government runs at the moment.
Right.
So it's almost the same as all the schemes put together. That's also the amount that goes into subsidies at the moment, around 3.2 lakh crore. Now, the only way to do this is to which the data analytics head of Congress made clear, this will be a center and state shared scheme. It is not a central scheme. Let's presume a 60-40 ratio that gives around 2 lakh crores that center needs to put out of its kitty. It can shore up around 50,000 to 60,000 crores right away, I presume. The others will come down, and I think again Mr. Chakravarti made it clear, there will be, as he called, rationalization of other schemes.
Right. Is there
space to do that? Yes, if the government wants to do that. They already has cash transfer schemes, which I presume logically would get subsumed if it wants to do this.
Okay.
Now, the part which is not clear is how would the beneficiaries get chosen and the logic it used to reach that amount of 6,000 rupees.
Right. I think those are two important points. I'll try and see if I can get some clarity from Sharmista. Sharmista, is this a scheme that has been thought through or just announced in haste simply to try to counter the BJP's PM-KISAN? I mean, you know, the point being raised, how, for instance, will you identify these beneficiaries? Because from what I understand, there is no survey so far, correct me if I'm right, which has actually gone and done household to household study of income levels.
There has been a lot of deliberations on this scheme, and it has to be, the survey has to be done absolutely starting from the block level, from the village level. We do have, we have come across this 6,000 rupees after doing a lot of studies and getting a lot of data that about the poorest of the poor, you know, they earn about 6,000 to 7,000 rupees per month. So this is to ensure that, you know, every family, they get about 12,000 rupees per month, about 72,000 rupees per year. Now, whether rationalization of the other subsidies and all, of course, you know, those things are needed to be smoothed out. So that is not a very big issue. But the whole point of this scheme is that this is the greatest poverty alleviation program in the world. You know, when MGNREGA was started,
I mean,
you know, this kind of questions were raised by people that how are they going to, you know, allocate jobs?
Right.
Yeah.
But, you know, when you, Dr. Mayaram, you know,
But we did
easy.
Manrega, and Manrega are successfully running, is ran for more
okay.
than a decade.
Okay,
more
Dr. Mahara.
Okay. And even the staunchest opposed, people who staunchly opposed Manrega are also now saying that it is a great scheme.
Okay, Dr. Mahiram.
It was the brainchild of Rahul Gandhi ji.
Okay, Dr. Mahiram, as a seasoned bureaucrat, tell us that, you know, on paper, you can make any sort of announcement, say this is the greatest scheme in the world, but realistically, do you think something like this, which has not been tried before, this level of cash transfer is both logistically and financially feasible, the Congress scheme?
Srinivasan, I think the questions that have been asked in the media and the questions that you're asking today are perhaps not the right questions to ask.
Okay.
Obviously, once the scheme is announced, then you go down, to the drawing board and then you start writing the scheme. Let me remind you that when abolition of Zamindari took place, did you think that in the early 50s there was any technology available to do it, to go out and take back the land from the landholders and give it to the poor people? The question of identification and all these issues were also there.
Right.
But it was done, and we have seen how it made a complete structural change in the rural economy in India.
Okay.
I would say the same thing about MG Narega. If you look at the numbers, in terms of the sheer numbers who were provided on-demand work, it's quite mind-boggling. In fact, when internationally I have gone and spoken about it to gatherings, for them to see the scale of it is very difficult.
Right.
So it is not difficult to put these programs in place. I think administration is very well geared to do that.
Right.
But the question before us should be, is it a necessary scheme?
Right.
Now, I think the first disruption in my mind was when MG Narega was introduced. For ages, the poor have subsidized Indian economy. You look at where the prices of everything rise. So government servants get increments and dearness allowance. The input prices keep going, steel prices go up, executives get their salaries.
Right.
Everyone is kind of, getting what their due
is
over a period of time.
Okay. All right.
Look at how the wages of the landless, skilled, semi-skilled and unskilled labor did
right
before MG Narega was put in place.
Okay,
so
you're saying
what I'm trying to say
that it's desirable.
That if you need to eradicate poverty in this country, you will need to have disruptive policies.
Okay, so that's
I know it is difficult, but in my opinion, this is going to be one of those tremendously powerful schemes to eradicate poverty in the country.
All right, okay, that's quite a strong endorsement, I must say, of the Congress scheme. Is the BJP rattled? Because, you know, Mr. Jaitley comes out and says this is a bogus scheme, this is not implementable. Then he makes the argument that we are already transferring more money through an existing basket of subsidies. How is that an argument? I mean, that all governments are doing.
Whenever you say something, so your history speaks.
Hmm.
History always speaks.
Okay.
What Jawaharlal Nehru said in the first parliament.
Let's not 30 to 40 lakhs people
were staying in the slums, and he said this is same for the country and I will do for them.
But let's not look
when
at
Indira
Nehru.
Gandhi said Garibi Hatao, it was in crores.
Okay.
And when Sonia Gandhi left in 2014, it was 10 to 15 crores staying in the slums.
Yeah.
This happened to the Garibi Hatao Nara. And now Congress lies people in last 7 decades so many times that
you are saying this is they're not
nobody is going to believe
this.
Them. Nobody is going to let them say anything.
I see.
But they lies the people so many times
right.
that people will not listen them. And
I'm asking you something else. I'm saying forget whether they are able to implement this or not. For that they have to first win the election. That itself we are not very certain. But do you support the scheme? Do you support the Nyaya scheme?
We are giving more than that. We are giving more than that. But
do you support this scheme?
We empower the people.
Do you support this scheme? You're not answering yes or no.
Our government is giving
okay.
more than that.
Okay.
But
we are in the favor that we should empower the people.
Okay.
So that country should also be empowered and people.
Okay, Sharmista, very, very quickly, time not is like up. That. 10 seconds. 10 seconds, Sharmista, time is up.
BJP has got the habit of opposing every pro-poor scheme. They opposed Manrega and then they praised it sky high.
What happened to Indira Awas Yojana?
That's why I was worried about this extra 10 seconds.
Where is the housing? We'll have to cut out.
We'll come back. We'll continue this. We're out of time. Thank you so much for watching Reality Check. Good night.